What's up, guys? I'm here on my favorite corner of Main Street, and we have some exciting things that we're doing today. We are going around all of the parks, and we are trying all of the new Little Mermaid snacks in honor of the new film. I know that there's some at Magic Kingdom, and I know there's some at Hollywood Studios and also Disney Springs, so I'm really excited to try them, see what we think of them, and have a fun day. So if you haven't already, be sure to like and subscribe so you don't miss my new videos, and let's go do this. Okay, so I am here in Fantasyland. I went ahead and walked over to Friar's Nook. We're about to hop in line for that. It's right across from Seven Dwarfs Mine Train and the carousel. So I know here at Friar's Nook they have a drink, and then I believe right across they also have an ice cream for the Little Mermaid. So we're gonna hop in line for both of these. And here are the two snacks they have here. They have the Bubbles of the Sea for $6.99. and then the Divinely Diabolical for $7.99. So we're gonna be getting both of these and trying them. Okay, so first up we have the Bubbles of the Sea. This one is a lemon guava pineapple green tea with boba in it, and it looks sparkly. It doesn't really look anything like the picture, if I'm being honest. I've kind of tried stirring it, and there is a lot of glitter in there. I don't know if you can really see it. We're gonna try though and see how it tastes. So I'm not the biggest fan of green tea, if I'm being honest. I do definitely taste green tea in this. It's not bad though. I think all of the other fruit flavors kind of help balance it out. And I do like the boba. It is refreshing for a hot park day like today. I'd probably give this one like a 7.5 out of 10. When it comes to design though, I'm kind of upset. The picture is like a really pretty light purpley, and this is kind of just like green and purple. I don't know, but it's still a good option, and if you like green tea, you'll like this a lot. Okay, and then we have the Divinely Diabolical, and this is basically just a cookies and cream shake. Nothing more than that. It has like purple whipped cream and then seashells on top, so we're just gonna try it. Pretty standard cookies and cream shake. I do like mine to have cookie like pieces in it, and this doesn't. It's pretty smooth, but it's still really good. I'd probably give this one like an 8 out of 10. Like I said, nothing special, but there's not really very many options in the parks to get cookies and cream shakes. So it's fun seeing one here. I'm trying to space these out because all of the new Little Mermaid snacks that they introduced are sweet. So you have like milkshakes, ice creams, and drinks making up the vast majority of it. So I'm trying to space them out. There's an ice cream cone right next to these snacks, and I decided to wait and hold off on those. I'm probably gonna eat something savory and then go get that one next. That way I'm not just hitting sweet after sweet after sweet, back to back to back. I really should bring people with me when I do these, but we live and we learn. Anyways, I'm gonna finish these and then we're gonna head over to get the next snack. Hi, Tigger.
Hi, everybody.
Aw. Hi, Pooh Bear. Oh, thank you. My character voice makes me laugh so hard because every time I talk to a character, it goes up like 3 octaves, and I don't even sound like myself, and I don't know why I do it, but I can't stop. Also, you may be wondering why I was coming from that angle if I was in the back of Fantasyland. Well, I forgot my charger, so I had to go get a new one because my phone is like at 3% because I didn't charge it this morning. Anyways, we are back over by Friar's Nook at Storybook Treats, and we're gonna be getting the ice cream cone that they have for the Little Mermaid. Okay, I cannot find anywhere to eat this. It is so busy in this park. But we have it. I can't believe it hasn't melted yet. So this is the Little Mermaid cone. I forget the actual name of it, but it was like $6.99, I think. And it's strawberry Dole Whip with purple cheesecake soft serve. Here is a better look at it. It is about to fall apart. I've been holding it for like 3 minutes now. So honestly, it's doing a pretty good job of staying intact. Okay, so we're trying this now. Let's go for it. So I went ahead and I got a cup for it and I threw it in there. Definitely ask for that because it will melt on you and quickly. Overall, I think it's pretty good. I think it's a fun snack, well-themed. I don't really get a lot of the cheesecake flavor. I get more strawberry, but I like strawberry, so I'm not mad about that. There's nothing really you can do about the heat. I mean, it's an ice cream cone, so it's like $6.99, like I said. Really fun treat. Honestly, I'm not mad about it. And now that it's in a cup, my hands aren't going to get sticky, so I can walk around and eat this, and we can head to our next snack. Since we are doing this giant Little Mermaid snack challenge, I figured it's only fitting that we also do the ride. I'm even debating getting in line to meet Ariel. I wanted to meet the live action Little Mermaid, but she's only out until 4:30. So we definitely won't make that, but let's go ahead and do this ride.
I'll start at the beginning. I was born from a small
So it says it's posted at a 25 minute wait. I think that probably means it's going to be less than that. Whatever, let's go. Okay, so it actually probably is going to be a 25 minute wait, but that's still not that long. So I'm just gonna go ahead and wait here. We're in the shade and the air conditioning, so it's nice. Okay, that was wonderful. I always love getting to see Ariel, and I don't see her very often. I have not been in the grotto in the longest time, and honestly, it's such a cute meet and greet location. So I'm glad that we did that. I believe we only have one more snack left at Magic Kingdom before we're done with these snacks here. So we're gonna head over and grab that right now. Okay, and so here is the final snack at Magic Kingdom. It is a drink. It's a seaside something. I am not doing good with the names today. But it's a pina colada slush with blue curacao and boba pearls. So we're gonna try this. Also, I forgot to mention, I think this was like $5.49 pre-tax. So, nice drink. It comes a little more filled up. I can't talk today. It's usually more filled than this. I spilled some of it. Also, Audrey and Tyler at that location are wonderful. She said that she liked my Beauty and the Beast necklace, which I do too. My friend Krista made it for me. Anyways, I've talked enough. Let's try it. Cheers. This is the best thing I've had today. I love this drink. Ah, and it's limited time. It's always the limited time things that I love the most. I give this a 10 out of 10. This is my favorite thing I've had today, by far. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this drink and walk back over to Main Street. And I think from there, I'm going to hop in my car. And I did not like that. Hop in my vehicle and head over to Hollywood Studios. And we're gonna go hit their snack. Over there. So overall, pretty successful Magic Kingdom Little Mermaid snacks now. I enjoyed all of them. They're all refreshing. I think also trying them all back to back to back probably would make a little bit of a difference. They're all very fruity and tropical, which is very fitting though. So I think coming back and getting like one or two another time would also be a lot of fun. Alrighty guys, we made it to Hollywood Studios. Now there's only one snack that we're getting here, and it's over by Tower of Terror. So we're gonna head over there now and grab it.
All right, so we made it over to Hollywood Scoops, and this is the shake that we're going to be getting. I'm showing this to you now because there are so many things in it I don't think I'm going to remember. Vanilla, mango, guava, ginger, topped with whipped cream and a pineapple guava seashell cake for $9.49.
Alrighty, I've got the shake here. Now, after tax, this was $10.11. So, and it is dripping. We're going to try it before it gets all over my hands. Cheers. Save yourself. This one gets like a 3 out of 10. It's not very good. I taste mainly ginger. I think if it didn't have the ginger in it, it would maybe be a little better. Not gonna be my favorite. Did I say 2 or 3 out of 10? I think I'm gonna go with 3 out of 10 for this milkshake. I probably need to try the cake too. Okay, I tried it off camera, the cake part of it, because I can't find a table and it was way too messy to try and grab. The cake was not good either. Honestly, this one was just really messy, really big, and the flavors were not there. I definitely don't get this one. Ask if you can stop somebody who has it and ask if you can take a picture with it and then move along with your day. That was the only snack we were trying to hit at Hollywood Studios. So we're done with Hollywood Studios now, and we're gonna head on to Disney Springs. Alrighty, we made it to Disney Springs. Now there are two Little Mermaid snacks here. There is one that we are going to try and one that we are just going to look at. So our first stop is going to be the ganachery. Okay, and so here we are. I don't think I've actually ever been in here before. So here is the inside of the ganachery. Now for the snack we're getting today, you can actually just pull it right off the shelf. It is salted caramel ganache and it has milk chocolate with it too. So this is a $7 snack. Now I will say it's definitely a little smaller than I thought it would be, but we're gonna get it and try it. So we're gonna do a cheers and try. Wow, this is really good. It's really good chocolate. I mean, it's a ganachery. But this is really yummy. I love the little kick of salt. Honestly, I could use a little more of it, but I love milk chocolate and I really enjoy this. Now, the last Little Mermaid snack is over at Amorette's Bakery, and I'm not going to get it, but I've heard it's really cute, so we're just gonna go look at it.
Well, we just arrived at Amorette's Bakery, and this is what I was wanting to show you guys. They have a Little Mermaid cake here. It's passion fruit, coconut filling, pineapple jam, kiwi, and cream cheese mousse. And it's for $22. I do not think I can stomach any more sweets today, but I did want to come and show you it.
Okay, we found the cake and it's on such a lovely display. It looks like it's all edible and made out of chocolate. I see some shells and seahorses and starfish. And then you have the cake in the center. If I was not B-R-O-K-E, I would get this and eat it, and actually I wouldn't eat it. I would just display it in my household and never touch it. But it's really gorgeous, and honestly, it sounds like it would be really good too.
All right, guys, I think that wraps up today's vlog. We tried all of the snacks except for that last cake. We had some really good ones and we had some really bad ones. But it was a fun time, and I think I'll honestly be getting quite a few of these again. They're really refreshing and good for hot days. I will not be eating fruit for the next 5 to 7 business days. So if you haven't already, be sure to like and subscribe so you don't miss my next vlogs, and I'll see you guys next time.